Well, hello, truth seekers and boat rockers. It's Bobby Faulkner here with you again, with my beautiful wife Liz behind the camera, and of course, Tony Holder from Down Under in the production area. Hey, Tony. Folks, that was part one that we had given you there on this series. We haven't given it a name yet. We left off with Oprah saying God created gay people.
I believe God created her gay. I believe God did that.
No. Anyway, rather than dig any more into that, let's just jump right in today with a little bit of Beyoncé. Folks, note the I am on the corner of the video there. If you got to stop it and go back and look at it on her video, you notice a seductive look and everything like that. And she's supposed to come from a Christian family? Yeah, hardly. Anyway, how about some more of the world views on God, the Bible here? Watch this.
Which passages of Scripture should guide our public policy? Should we go with Leviticus, which suggests slavery is okay, and that eating shellfish is an abomination? Or we could go with Deuteronomy, which suggests stoning your child if he strays from the faith? Or should we just stick to the Sermon on the Mount, a passage that is so radical that it's doubtful that our own Defense Department would survive its application? So before we get carried away, let's read our Bibles now.
Yeah, Obama, let's do that. Let's read our Bibles. Folks, he's mocking the Bible, in case you didn't pick up on that. Oh, what should we do? Go to Leviticus or what? You know, look, should we stone our kids? Should we do this? How about the Sermon on the Mount? I mean, he's mocking Jesus Christ, but everybody, Obama's a Christian. No, he's not. No, he's not. And I don't really care. This isn't a political thing. When you're mocking the Bible like that, I mean, really? We need to read our Bibles all right, rightly divided. Check this part. Folks, this stuff represents Satan. The lightning bolts on all these celebrities, the faces and stuff like that. That's, you know, Satan got... cast out of heaven like lightning. That's why they do that. That's why they do that, folks. Don't be fooled. Don't be fooled by that stuff. I'm not talking about, there's some people that get into the whole giving the horn sign and all these different, the sixes with the okay and all that. Whether it is or not, I'm not going to even worry about that stuff. But this stuff here, it's blatant. I mean, right there with the lightning bolts. So you might not think anything of it. You think, that's no big deal. This is part of the entire scheme of Satan to make sin glamorous, to make you think it's okay, that don't worry about it. Hey, it's not bothering me. They're not hurting me. Oh, it's just fashion. It's Hollywood. It's this, it's that, whatever. It's sin that these people are involved in. It makes things seem innocent, and it makes it look like it doesn't matter, but this is his plot to reel people in, especially our youth, folks. Let's watch Lady Gag Me. Yeah. So, note the apostles' names on the back of the jackets of the bikers she's riding with there, folks. Pretty crazy, isn't it? So she's in love with Judas, the betrayer of Jesus. She's in love with him. Folks, this trash is capturing our youth. You know how many people how popular she is. People like her. She is popular. I mean, hey, you don't have to listen to her to know. We're doing this because the youth are getting captured by this stuff. You don't even want to see the rest of that video. You want to go look it up for yourself, folks. We couldn't put that stuff on here. It is beyond despicable and horrific. It's disgusting stuff, folks. It's a total mockery of God and the Bible. I'm in love with Judas. I mean, come on. You know, you don't have to be a genius to figure. Part of the lyrics, I'll just mention part of the lyrics. I'm just a holy fool, oh baby. He's so cruel, but I'm still in love with Judas, baby. Wow. Look at the rest of the lyrics up, folks. Decide for yourself. I mean, wow. Our youth are getting bombarded with this despicable satanic trash like this.
The frequency is weird, and you know it's sounding a little bit strange. And I'm like, if you don't get this right now, I swear to Lucifer. Now I swear to Lucifer, I'm gonna. You know.
Jesus, are you listening? Jesus, I'm confused. Because some people say that you only love a certain kind of person, with certain kind of beliefs, or background, or money, or color, or sexual orientation. But Jesus, you have blessed me. And I bleed to death every night, singing and dancing in front of 20,000 people, talking about love and unity. So I'm quite certain that Jesus must love everybody!
So folks, what you see, when you connect Satan's dots here, of all this stuff put together, and then again, you couple it with, it's all about the love. You know, I just love people. Jesus just loves everybody, and the love and power conferences, and it's all about the Christian love club and all this stuff. Folks, they've distorted this stuff so badly. This has multitudes thinking that this is okay, that it's just all acceptable. We're all sinners. We can't judge them. We have to try to win them over and just let them do that. And what I believe is not for this one, and that might be good for you, but it doesn't resonate with me, or whatever it is, folks. This is a tangled web that Satan has here. Man, he's got a flavor for every month out there, everything that's going on. He's weaved this web so great that hundreds of thousands, if not millions of people are snookered by this stuff, and they're going to hell. Now watch this so-called comedian here, Sarah Silverman.
So, what do you think about Elton John saying Jesus was gay?
Probably. I love you!
Wow, that was a loving flight, or what?
You know, that's not an insult. You know, a lot of people back then, a lot of guys had sex with each other. And if it's, I mean, it makes sense that he's gay. He's kind.
What level of gay would Jesus have been?
I guess 4.
So, folks, really? I mean, wow. Sarah Silverman there, and then, I mean, saying Jesus was gay. Elton John said Jesus was gay, and oh, he's on a level 1 to 10, he was a 4 as a gay.
What level of gay would Jesus have been?
I guess 4.
And men had, you know, sex with one another. I mean, really, folks? Wow. And then AC/DC and stuff. I mean, that's coming up here on this part here where that's Madonna doing that chant there. I mean, really, don't care if I go to hell. She was in the land down under there, unfortunately, where our brother Tony's at. But wow, I mean, folks, did you see the crowd? They're into it. They're loving it. They're chanting with her. Anyway, let's move on to this here. This is AC/DC. Thousands jumping up and down in unison, chanting, I'm on the highway to hell. Wow. Folks, the kids are, they're being sucked in by this stuff. I mean, really, do you not see this here? Satan is after the youth, folks. How about a little Van Halen for you? So, even though born again, it's for Israel, that's not for us, but Sammy Hagar there singing with Van Halen because they booted David Lee Roth at the time, saying you don't have to die and go to heaven, you don't have to stay here and be born again. Wow. And the kids they're flocking to this stuff, folks. There's messages here being taught. Some people say, I just listen to the music, I don't listen to the words. Hey, it's penetrating. If this is not crystal clear, we don't know what is. If this is not crystal clear, the lyric content, the music, it's drawing them in. I mean, folks, and so many of these so-called churches out there, they play AC/DC and Metallica. I heard somebody doing Prince, Purple Rain as a so-called worship song. When Doves Cry as a worship song, I guess because a dove, you know, dove of the Holy Spirit. Folks, really? Really? I love music. I was in music. I mean, we love all kinds of music, but do you not see what's going on here, folks? This stuff is, I mean, so-called worship services, they're playing this stuff? Anyway, well, how about a little of this?
Oh, I feel the spirit of Taylor Swift.
Swift, how many of you got saved on that one? I know I did. Yeah, I got saved on that spirit of Taylor Swift.
Oh, I feel the spirit of Taylor Swift.
Yeah, I kind of felt that spirit of Taylor Swift coming on, so I thought we'd drop that in there so we could get saved by it. It's crazy, folks. Watch this. So these are depictions of Jesus haters poisoning our society, poisoning our youth, folks, like this. Ozzy Osbourne mocking Jesus, of course. The Pope. That's the Pope there. Well, it was one of the Popes. They have so many Popes, you know. They think. But the upside down cross. Did you not notice that, folks? Upside down cross. The Pope. Catholics are pagans, folks. Catholicism is a pagan religion. Okay, you better check that one out. And I mean, is this not clear? How about this here?
A lot of people come up here and they thank Jesus for this award. I want you to know that no one had less to do with this award than Jesus. He didn't help me a bit. So all I can say is, suck it, Jesus, this award is my God now.
Now that is a so-called another funny person, another comedian, Kathy Griffin, if you recall, again, no political stuff here, was holding the severed head of our president and caught more than just a little flack over that. Did you hear what she said? Getting her award, I don't know how she ever got an award for doing what, for being an idiot, but she says, Jesus, suck it. This is my God now. Wow. This is why we put the warning here, folks. So kids, if you want to have your kids watch this and see the reality of this stuff, as if maybe they're not already watching. Jesus, suck it. This is my God now. Where do you think she's going? Wow, folks. I mean, really, if this is not clear, then how about this one right here?
Okay, so the kids are learning how to burn a Bible.
Then watch it burn.
Jesus Christ, I hate you.
Okay, people, save that one for towards the last year. That's somebody's kid. That's someone's son. That's someone's child there. Saying, I hate you, Jesus, and this is how to burn the Bible. You don't see this? You don't see Satan's after our kids, folks? This is horrific. This is horrific stuff. That's somebody's kid. That could be your kid. That could be our kid. Burning a Bible. It's not the burden the Bible is going to send somebody to hell, folks. It's behind it, and he hates Jesus. So obviously, he knows nothing about right doctrine. He knows nothing about how to be saved. That's someone's son. Well, folks, this stuff was pretty disturbing, to say the least. And this is, want you to see how false doctrine plays into all this stuff here, folks. It's really crazy. I mean, it's just unbelievable. That's it. I held back the tears on that one, on that last thing, man. It just about got me, but I held it back. Anyway, that was tough stuff, man. Good luck with it.